So, hello and welcome to my Let's Play Fallout New Vegas. And last time we were playing, we were heading to the NCR prison or correctional facility to free a guy there. Let's see, quests my kind of town. And in free ex-sheriff from there, so he would become the sheriff of Prim. One thing I want to try is okay, I don't have authority glasses. Let's see how I look. No, wrong. Oh, there you go. Oh, cool. So, then you can try out this weapon. Let's see, we were using the varmint rifle and it does 11 damage. We have also this cowboy repeater which does 20 damage, so we're going to use that one. Let's see how the scope is okay, I guess. I mean, it's not the scope on the varmint rifle. I mean, let's see. Okay, he isn't hostile, so okay. Maybe if I took a powder ganger outfit, maybe I could actually get in here. Let's see if there was anyone here whose outfit I could have taken. I'm not sure if I played this game a week ago, so. Don't really take this dynamite. It's a what? A spork. Okay. And I think I'd like to try out the powder ganger outfit to see if they'll still attack me while I'm wearing it. And to do that, I need to kill a powder ganger, and I think there were some powder gangers that way. I know I'm just currently wasting time, but I really want to try infiltrating into the powder ganger society. It's not the right word, but you know what I mean. So run forest. Actually, it's I can't remember if there were any powder gangers there, because that would be awesome. Don't need to run any further. I might pick up some cactus, because it was right there teasing me. Please, I wanna have some powder gangers here. No. Okay. Maybe they were uphill. Yeah, they were uphill. I mean, they weren't maybe you're a powder ganger. Let's see, pry. Okay, cool. Bright Brotherhood robe. Does it like you make me a bright brotherhood guy? Who are you?
Hello there. It's good to see a friendly face. I almost took you for a raider, I did. Name's Malcolm. Malcolm Holmes.
Pleased to meet you.
Don't suppose you'd care to trade. I'm missing a few essentials and screw this. Lying just ain't in my nature. I'll tell it to you straight. I've been following you for a good bit now.
Why?
It started off innocently enough. I was traveling, as I often do, and happened to observe you picking up one of those blue star caps. You didn't show any reaction to it, so I figured you didn't know what you'd gotten your hands on.
What's so special about these caps?
There's an old wasteland legend that says somewhere out there is a fabulous treasure from before the war. Those caps with the blue star on them, the tale goes, are the key to that treasure. They're called Sunset Sarsaparilla Stars.
What kind of treasure?
No one knows. Money, weapons, water. It is, or maybe was, something of value, and that's enough to get people motivated.
Okay, where I can find more of those caps?
All over the place. The easiest place to find them is unopened bottles of Sunset Sarsaparilla. You'd think they'd all have been picked clean by now, but somehow, new bottles keep appearing in the machines. Some say it's old Festus that does it, hoping someone will finally collect enough caps to earn the treasure. Other than bottles, you'll just have to scavenge. You can find caps in the unlikeliest of places, and blue star caps are no exception.
You mentioned someone named Festus.
It's said that the treasure is guarded by a man named Festus, and he's the one who asked for the blue star caps. It's also said he's been around since the war, standing a lonely vigil, waiting for someone to come and take the treasure off his hands. That'll make him pretty damn old, but I've met a few people in my travels who claim they actually met him, and they weren't the lying type either.
So you'll collect these caps too?
Nah, I gave it up years ago. Too dangerous. And even if I did still collect them, I'd tell you the same. There's people out there so mad with the idea of treasure that they'll attack strangers just on the suspicion that they have some of those caps.
Thanks for the info. I'll be going now.
No problem. If you do end up trying to collect more stars, watch out for a man named Alan Marks. He's killed several people for their stars already.
Okay. I mean, you seem suspicious too, because you were following me. Don't know. This monk's rope seems okay too. But I'll trade back. I'll use my reinforced leather armor, which gives me more protection, and I'll quickly see sleep. I guess I'll eat and drink something soon. Okay, I think we're reaching the point where we killed those powder gangers. I wish I could run faster. This could be Oblivion and I could be mage and casting 45 speed on myself. It'll easy make things so much easier. Name. What were you wearing? Okay, metal armor. That seems heavy. And I'm already almost over encumbered, so nay. You were wearing a powder gang guard armor. It weighs much though. Can take the dynamite. Let's see. Yeah, there are guys down there too. And I guess one of you were wearing the normal powder gang. Yes, you. Weight 3. And I'll just have to get rid of something. Let's see, items 8, something I can eat, so let's see. So, and something that weighs a lot also. Let's see, I'll eat a pork and beans, and then I'll eat some, drink some dirty water, because I have shitloads of dirty water. Then I have also, it's okay, these cases, the carton of cigarettes. Okay, let's see anything. Okay, can I keep the snow globe? So I think somewhere I heard these are worth quite a lot of money. I'm not sure where, just something I heard. So I'll be keeping those. Well, it those if I manage to find more. Let's see if I can what kind of weapons I have. Binoculars, I'm keeping those. Caravan shotgun. So I need way as much combat knife. I'll probably sell it. That thing weighs a lot. Dynamite, frag mine, laser, RCW. Just was cool. A single shotgun.